Good morning, Hagerman Christian Center. I know you might be wondering, what am I doing on the video? Well, this morning I chose to bring the Word of God to you through the video because my friend and one of ours here at Hagerman Christian Center, Dylan, he was looking forward to come and to hear the Word of God, hear me preach and be ministered by the Word. So, Dylan, if you're not here, then maybe I look like a clown, but I hope you're here. So welcome to Christian Center. We're delighted to have you, and I'm looking forward to see you face to face when I get back from California. But I want to welcome you. I welcome you back. He's been in training. He's been military training, and now he is back with his family and today, this morning, in our fellowship. Welcome, and come on, give him a big round of applause to him and to the many, many more young people that are training to defend the freedoms and liberties of our great country, United States of America. Thank you so very much. Also, I want to say happy birthday to Polly. I'm not going to say her age, but we are so happy to have you among us and for the blessing that you are to all of us. And thank you for playing the piano every time at the end of the service. And so thank you, thank you, thank you. And happy birthday. I don't know if the kids sang happy birthday to you, but I wanted to say happy birthday to you. And for everyone else whose birthday's anniversary, happy birthday to you. May the Lord bless you. I want to bring to you a message that has been brewing in my heart for a while, and it is about the book of Philippians, and specifically on chapter 4, verse 4 through 6, and it is choosing the life of joy. We live in a society where joy seems to be absent. Smiles are minimal. And anxiety and depression is rampant. And I'm not talking about non-believers. I'm talking about believers. I'm seeing faces that are down, frustrated hearts and confused minds. And it seems like the Christians are losing their joy or are choosing not to walk in joy because life is so hard, because perhaps the situations you're facing today is robbing you of the joy that God wants you to have. Perhaps issues in your marriage, perhaps issues in your finances, your friendships, your relationships, your boss that is a pain in the neck, and perhaps a little lower. And all these things is robbing you the joy of experiencing a full life in Christ. I want to submit to you that there are reasons why we could and should choose joy. There are a must to do in order for us to live a life full of joy. And I'm not talking about walking on the streets of Hagerman or the Magic Valley, sorry, with a smile on your face and people look at you like you think you're a clown or a fool. No, what I'm talking about is that in the midst of your circumstances, you still have joy in your heart. You still have peace in your mind because you have chosen the path of the Word of God for you. So let's go into the Word of God. And if you are so kind to stand up and let's look in the book of Philippians chapter 4, verse 4 to 6. I'm going to put it on the screen, and I would like for you, I'm reading from the New Living Translation. And he says, always be full of joy in the Lord. This statement, first statement of this passage, is where I am going to focus the majority of my sermon today. Always be full of joy in the Lord. I say it again, rejoice. Let everyone see that you are considerate in all you do. Remember, the Lord is coming soon. Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank Him for all He has done. Then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds anything we can understand. His peace will guard your hearts and minds as you live in Christ Jesus. In order for you, when you look at the passage in the scripture, to understand why is it that Paul is writing to the church and it is addressing the issue of joy, is because in the church there were some disagreements among people. There were some issues happening among the people, issues that were affected because of life, issues that the Bible doesn't tell me exactly what were the issues, but there were disagreements that were causing the joy to be taken away from the people. It was causing for everyone to be affected by the influence of this situation. And isn't it true when someone in your family has an issue with mom or dad or with a brother or a sister, it's not just affect the individual that is involved in the situation, but it's everyone around. They feel it, they sense it, they walk into a room where there's tension, they feel the environment. And that's why Paul is addressing the church, because he does not want the church of the living God to be in an atmosphere where joy is absent. Because if joy is no longer in the house of God, if joy is no longer in the hearts of God's people, then it will be a place of just religion without life. Because when there is life in a place, there should be joy. And when joy is present, then strength is present, because the Bible says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. But choosing the life of joy requires you and me to accept at least three things. Number one, and it is on the verse that we read at the beginning. And verse number four says, always, always be full of joy in the Lord. And there is, number one, the mandate of joy. It's not a suggestion to follow. It is a mandate. We are commanded by God to obey this. If we don't understand it this way, then we can think, well, maybe I could be full of joy when I want, when it's convenient, when people treat me right, when people is nice to me. No, this is always the commandment. The mandate of joy is always, not just on a Sunday morning when people are watching you, not just on a Wednesday when you come to Bible study, but it's every day when you go to work, when you run your business, when you work for somebody, when you're driving, when you go to the drive-thru, or when you have to wait 30 minutes on a Wendell Hegeman Road because they're taking forever and there are no signs and there's no signals and there's no warning about anything. You just have to wait until they move. You must choose always to be full of joy, not just when everything flows your way. Second thing, there is the condition of joy. You're going to choose the life of joy, then there is a condition. He says, be full of joy, not partially. Some of you are running empty. Some of you are running half a tank or a quarter of a tank or three quarters of a tank. But the Bible tells me that we got to be full of joy. And the reason why I can be full of joy, my friends, is because my joy is not conditioned to my circumstances. My joy is not conditioned to how much I have, how much I own, the house that I live in, the car that I drive, the money that I have in my account, the investments that I have. No, ladies and gentlemen, my joy is full because it's in the Lord. And here comes the third aspect or requirement in order for us to have a life of joy. We must accept the basis of joy. So we have the mandate of joy that is always, the condition of joy that is be full of joy. joy completely. And third, the basis of joy is in the Lord. See, many people think if I marry the right person, then I will be with joy in my life. I can tell you about people that says if I divorce someone, then I'll be full of joy. I'm just kidding. But anyhow, you know what I'm talking about. There's people around us that they think their joy comes from the stuff they have, from the things they own, for the dreams they have. But the joy needs to come because in Jesus Christ, we have the assurance, we have the experience. Experience, my friends, if you're not experiencing joy, it's because there's something lacking in your life. And I'll tell you, there are reasons why we ought to be full of joy. Let me just take you to a few of them. I think I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 reasons to choose joy. Number one, verse number 5 says, remember, Jesus is coming soon. In other words, my friends, this is has a time and a place, but it's not forever. Whatever we're confronted, it's only for a limited time. The Bible tells me that Jesus is coming soon. If you believe in this, if you trust in God, if you know He's returning and His return is imminent, then you're going to be rejoicing every day because you're going to get up in the morning and say, this could be the day that Jesus is coming back for me. This could be the morning that Jesus will take me up in heaven and live for eternity with Him. That's a number one reason to choose joy, because Jesus is coming back soon. Number two reason, God is giving us prayer as the antidote for depression and anxiety. People are full of depression, of anxiety, of the things to come, or the things that they not accomplish. Depression is about what they couldn't get, what they couldn't achieve, what they could not come to realization. And anxiety is for the things they want to have, they want to dream, they want to achieve, but they haven't gotten yet. But let me tell you, the antidote for all of these, The answer for the problems that we're facing in this area is that when we have prayer, we know that we can come to God. And number three, you can tell God everything. You can tell God everything. It's not just a person that you tell a little bit or someone that you trust the most, you tell everything. No, but when God is in the scene, when you choose the life of joy, you're going to be able to express to God everything. You're not going to withhold anything. You know why? Because even though God knows our heart and God knows our mind, we still can express that. It's therapeutic. How do you say that? Therapeutic? Therapeutic. In other words, it helps you when you're praying. And some people call it venting. Well, the fact that is, when I can vent to God, when I can share with God, there's peace. There's something that happens in my life that I feel better already. Isn't it true that when you have an issue in your life and you talk it over with your wife, you feel like something, oh, I feel good. Or you talked over with your best friend and you feel a lot better. Imagine, He has given us prayer as a tool of communication to the one that can answer our prayer, to the one that can resolve our issues, to the one that can give us hope and strength, to the one that has the answer for what we need. Oh, I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, when you understand that you can be on the phone for hours with someone trying to ask for help, and that person can talk to you all you want, but he's not able to help you. But when you talk to someone like Jesus, to God, to the Holy Spirit, it is a person that can help you. It is a person that can lift you up. It is a person that can strengthen you. You know that joy will come. Maybe you're going through a storm. Maybe you're going through the vicissitudes of life and adversity that you can't handle. Remember, joy comes in the morning. Joy comes because every morning we have a new opportunity to live again, to breathe again, and to receive the grace of God again. Number four, gratitude. When the reason to choose joy is because gratitude can take you far more than you can imagine. Verse number six says, in the last part of verse number six says, tell God what you need and thank Him for all he has done. Oh, man, you can tell, say, God, thank you for my life. Thank you for my wife. Thank you for this house. Thank you for this church fellowship that I can call home. Thank you because they can preach the word of God. Thank you for my family. Thank you for my children. Thank you for my grandson. Thank you for everyone. Even thank you for my enemies, because they make me be tested in love and compassion and grace and favor. Thank you, God, for the rain. Thank you for the good weather. Thank you for the bad weather. Thank you for the snow. And thank you for everything. When you are thankful for everything, then your life is full of joy. But if you're always depressed, if you're always complaining and whining, oh, well, I have this problem, I have that problem, well, I don't know how to fix this, I don't know how to fix that, and you constantly turn your mind into a negative world, then your life is choosing the wrong path. There's a reason to choose joy, because when we are grateful and gratitude is in your life, people are going to notice. People are going to want to be around you because you're no longer negative and depressed and frustrated and confused. No, now you're a person with joy. You're a person that has so much joy that you're giving away joy, that you're passing peace to someone else. You are not just an object in life that you're trying to survive. You are an individual with the grace of God that you are striving and thriving in life because the joy of God is in you. Gratitude can take you far more than you can imagine. And the last one, the reason to choose joy, is because it will allow you to experience peace. The Bible says, His peace will guard your hearts and minds as you live in Christ Jesus. It says, then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds anything we can understand. See, even when we don't understand, we receive the shalom peace that goes beyond our understanding. When you lose a loved one, when you're betrayed or spoke against it, or you feel affected just like, or simply you're getting old and you can't do the things I used to do. You don't have the energy, the stamina, or the strength to do it, and you feel kind of depressed because you used to do things and you have energy and accomplish things. But let me tell you, when you choose the joy of the Lord, then you will experience the peace of God. That does not make any sense sometimes, that He will give you peace in the middle of a storm, that will give you hope when there seems no hope. It will give you life when it seems that you're running out of it. It will give you energy when you think you no longer have it. You are choosing the life of joy. It's a decision that we make, and the reasons are plenty enough for us to choose a life of joy. So now let me conclude with this. What are the results of choosing a life of joy? It's right there in the text. It's right in the text, my friends. And it says in verse number seven, the last part, His peace will guard your hearts and minds as you live in Christ Jesus. This is the result, my friend. When you choose a life of joy, your heart and your mind will be guarded as you live in Christ Jesus. Look, an unhealthy mind, it will think the wrong thing, the false things. It will give wrong assumptions, wrong ideas. A heart that is sick is self-destruction. A mind that is sick is destruction around those around you. When the mind is sick, when the heart is sick, you will harbor unforgiveness and bitterness and frustration and addictions and pain and all kinds of things are negative. But when you choose the life of joy, when you know that it is a mandate that always to be full of joy, and at the same time that your joy comes from God, then your heart will be pure and your mind will be healthy. You will be able to love. You will be able to give. You will be empowered to live for Jesus Christ, because the end result is for you to live in Christ Jesus, but with a healthy mind and with a healthy heart. The Bible is very clear. If we follow Him, if we choose joy, we will have a different world. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, how it could be so different in our communities, in our churches around America, in our lives, in our families, if everyone chooses the path of joy. And again, let me emphasize this. I am not talking about that you are like a clown walking in the church and in the streets. No, I'm telling you that the peace of God, that the joy of Christ will be self-evident in you. Your eyes will testify of that. Your demeanor, your behavior, your words, your kindness, your compassion will be evident. And people are urgently needing a church that is full of joy, not full of baloney, not full of air, not full of programs and activities without life, but they're looking for a church that is full of Jesus Christ, full of life, full of joy, full of peace. My question to you today is, do you want to be the church of Christ that is full of joy, or do you want to be a person or an individual, family, or whatever, that you choose not to follow Jesus and not to follow joy? You have the answer. Again, I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand. I'm not going to ask you to come to the altar, but I'm going to ask you to be sincere and honest and open your heart and your mind, and you tell Jesus, I do not have joy, and I need you, God. I need you. I need the joy in my life, because lately I've been running low. I've been running on empty of my joy, and I need the joy of the Lord to be my strength. There are so many of you, they're dragging their feet in life. They're dragging your feet to church, dragging your feet to serve God, dragging your feet to be committed to Christ. It is because you're running low on joy, because the joy of the Lord will be your strength. You need, again, accept that the mandate of joy is to be always full of joy. It is also to be filled completely of joy, and it is in the Lord. Is the only place, is the only person, it is the only way. What will be your answer today? What will be your decision? I pray and I hope that your decision is to follow the reasons of the joy of God. And the reasons are already in our heart, in our mind. And I pray that the Holy Spirit will remind you constantly that the reason why we can choose joy is because He's coming soon. We have been given the tool of prayer to communicate with God and be anxious for nothing and depressed for nothing. That we can come to God and tell Him everything. That we can have gratitude in our heart and thank Him for everything. And He will allow His peace to be experienced by all of us, individually and in community. May the Lord bless you. Would you please stand and let's pray today. What will be your decision? What is your choice? I, as of me and my house, we will serve the Lord. What is your decision? Don't run halfway, three quarters, one quarter. Run full of the joy of God, that people can see that there is worth it to follow Jesus, that it is worth it to serve Him, that it is worth it to be in the house of God. Even if it's a message through the screens, but you know that God's word has been preached to you today, and now is the time of action. What would this be for you? It will be manifested on Monday, Tuesday, and all the way through Saturday and every day. People will see it. Invite Him and tell Him who gave you that joy, and His name is Jesus. And tell Him that there is a place where the Word of God is being preached and where Jesus has been lifted up. And invite them, But if they need a ride, bring them over. People need to know about Jesus Christ. He is the answer. He is what we're all looking for. And sometimes we don't realize it. But today, this word has been declared to you. Accept it, follow it, live it in Jesus' name. Father, we come to you. And I know that you know each person here this morning. You know their hearts, their condition, their sadness, their frustration, their sickness, their illness, their captivity, their different situations. But Father, we also are conscious that you know the potential of each one of your people here today. You know their potential. You know what they're capable of it when they are full of joy, when running full of your presence and full of peace. I pray that you will guide them and guard them and keep them so their heart and mind will be healthy to represent you everywhere they go. We thank you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Are you blessed this morning? Come on, shake hands with somebody as you go out and you want to join the lunch this morning. It will help missions and be able to help this church with 40 chairs that they needed for their church. So grab somebody, give them a hug, a kiss if it's your wife, share hands if it's someone that you don't know, but introduce yourself and tell them it was glad to see you in the house of God. I don't know what time is it, but I kept it short, and I pray you have a blessed week and a blessed day in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord bless you. Keep praying for us as we're driving back Monday morning and try to make it back here to Monday evening. God be with you. Amen. We're dismissed.
Rejoice, rejoice. joy.